It's 2023 and I've spent well over 6 months using an iPhone, and I'm gonna take you through my top 6 iPhone tricks that you should be using. Number 6, Grayscale. If you've ever found yourself on your phone up later than you should be, Grayscale can help. It makes your iPhone much less enticing to look at. To turn it on, go into Settings, search for Color Filters, select the result, tap Color Filters, then turn them on and select Grayscale. And to make it easier to turn on and off Grayscale, go into Settings, Control Center, and tap the plus button next to Accessibility Shortcuts. You'll now be able to turn Grayscale on and off in Control Center. Next up at number 5, back tap. You can simply just double tap or triple tap the back of your iPhone to cause it to do certain things. And yes, this feature does work with cases. To set this up, go into Settings, search for Assistive Touch, which is all one word, scroll down to get to back tap, and we have two options, double and triple tap. You can see when selecting either one, you can do a lot with this feature, like opening up the notification center, turning on the flashlight, opening the camera or an app switcher, a specific app, and yes, even triggering shortcuts. Trick number 4 is the app library. This feature replaces the pages of apps iPhone used to force you to scroll through and makes navigating your phone and finding apps much easier. But I've noticed on a lot of people's iPhones, they still have just those pages of app icons. And yes, Dad, I'm looking at you for this one. So here's how to make your iPhone easier to use with App Library. First, let's get rid of all the apps on your home screen. To do this, go into your home screen and tap and hold on your wallpaper, and then tap the dots towards the bottom of the home screen. Here you'll see all of your home screen pages. Go ahead and uncheck all of your home screen pages with just app icons. Once you do that, you'll have the option to delete these home screen pages by selecting the minus button at the top left corner of each page, which will just delete those pages, not your apps. And I'd recommend doing that, but in case you ever want to go back to having these pages, you can just leave them unchecked. I'd recommend keeping only 1 or 2 max home screen pages. That way, you only have to swipe 1 or 2 times to get to the app library. Your iPhone will automatically categorize and surface your most used apps in the app library folders. But to quickly get to any app, you can alternatively swipe down from any home screen or the app library itself and search for the name of your app. So now that you've cleaned up your home screen, what exactly are you supposed to put on it if not apps? That brings us to my number 3 trick, widgets. Widgets surface glanceable information from apps as well as your iPhone's operating system. To see all of the widgets you have available to add on your home screen, just tap and hold anywhere on the home screen to edit it, and then tap the plus button at the top left corner. You can scroll through all the widgets you can choose from, like music and podcast player widgets, maps, calendar, weather, battery status, Find My, and so many more. And with iOS 17, widgets are now dynamic, allowing you to do things like check off your grocery list or play and pause media without ever having to open up an app. Now, here's where the trick really comes in. With widgets, you can actually stack them into what are called smart stacks. Your iPhone will try and surface the correct stack at the right time based on your usage patterns, but they're also really easy to just swipe through as well. Another widget that's quite useful is Siri Suggestions. You'll notice at the bottom of my home screen, I have 8 apps, but these are actually from the Siri Suggestions widget, which will display 8 apps dynamically based on your usage patterns. And overall, I found the picks to actually be pretty good here. All right, coming in at my number 2 trick that you should be using on an iPhone, focus modes. Focus modes help you reduce distractions from your iPhone by temporarily silencing all notifications or allowing only specific ones to come through. By default, Apple gives you a few focus modes to start with, but you can also create your own custom ones for just about anything. When you set up a focus mode, you can choose the people in your contacts you want notifications from. You can also do the inverse as well by silencing specific contacts like friends while you're in your work focus. Same thing for notifications from specific specific apps, so you can mute your Discord server while at work. You can also link a customized lock screen and home screen for each of your focus modes. So for your work focus, you might want a work chat or email widget on your home screen, while in your fitness focus, you might want to prioritize fitness, workout, and media apps on your home screen. The last thing you can set up within a focus is a focus filter. These allow you to filter out certain things from apps on a specific device when a focus mode is enabled. You can also choose system filters as well, like turning on and off low power mode during your fitness focus. Now, once you have your focus mode set up, there are a couple of ways you can then trigger them. Some pre-built ones, like fitness and driving, can automatically turn on when you start a workout or you're driving. Others, like sleep, will turn on based on the sleep schedule that you set up in the health app. And for other focus modes, you can just open the control center, tap focus, and then select what mode you want to manually enable. And the last great thing about focus modes is they're universal. So when you turn on Do Not Disturb on your iPhone, it'll also turn on Do Not Disturb on your other Apple devices like your Mac, Apple Watch, etc. All right, and the number one trick that you should be using on an iPhone in 2023 is the Shortcuts app. Shortcuts is a powerful app built by Apple that helps you automate different things on your iPhone. The Shortcuts app has three sections: Shortcuts, Automations, and Gallery. Automations are a type of shortcut that is activated by an event rather than by a manual action, which is what shortcuts are triggered by. One of the more recent things I've used shortcuts for is programming the new action button found on the iPhone 15 Pro and 15 Pro Max. But you can also use shortcuts with that back tap and triple tap gesture that I talked about earlier. For my action button shortcut, I created a shortcut that gets the current focus status and Wi-Fi network name, and then I added some logic to the shortcut to turn on and off Do Not Disturb when it knows I'm on my home Wi-Fi, and then open up the camera app to take a photo when the phone is not connected to my home Wi-Fi network. Another thing I've used them for is solving issues. For example, when I put my Sony earbuds in and connect to my iPhone, they always seem to set the iPhone's media volume to 50%, which is too loud. With shortcuts, I could just easily get around the issue. I created a very simple automation for when my iPhone 15 Pro Max is connected to my WF-1000 XM5 earbuds, media volume is set to 25%. There are so many things you can do with shortcuts, and way more advanced stuff than what I just showed you. You can generate a music quiz from your Apple Music library, create memes, QR codes, GIFs, automatically share your ETA with loved ones, remove a background from a portrait photo, shorten a URL, and so much more. You can get some inspiration and download shortcuts others have made from the gallery section in the Shortcuts app. So those are my top 6 tricks for the iPhone this year. Let me know if you think I got it right, or you think I got my list wrong, and what else should have been on my list in the comments below. And consider giving this video a thumbs up if you liked it and found it helpful, and subscribe to the channel and our free monthly newsletter for more content on Apple and iPhone, like our upcoming guide on Siri shortcuts. And to see more of our videos on Apple and other tech products, you can get to those by clicking on the videos above. For 6 months later, I'm Josh Tedder. Thanks for watching.